Hi folks, Peach Mario back with how can users contribute to the governance model. This is the second part with which is a little bit more developer centric. Yeah. So on the main page, I go to community info, and with the community info, if I'm logged in, I don't have the right access at the moment. So this is telewiki.org, Senatus committee and the details. And here I have the possibility to fork the project. So it copies everything to my video. Need to give it a different name. Sorry. I'm forking it to my repository where I do have write access. And as you can see, I'm here now. If I say profile, this is my lab video profile. I have my personal projects, and there is the one which is called committee. I can rename it to my likings. That's not the problem. Okay, so let's say I want to change something in the README file. I go to the web IDE, which opens a full file tree. So I have a possibility to change several files at once or one by one per merge request. So let's start simple, just add two new lines at the end. Then you can see it says unstaged modifications. So this is a permanent save, so you don't need to take care so that it's not saved. I could open a new one, so you can see there is a tabbed view, and could create two changes. Then I'm here. I also can say create a new file or create a new directory or whatever. There is one important point. Also here, keep it simple. So if you want to change some typos, just go there and change one or two files, then it's easy to be merged. If you change all of them, then there will be a big discussion, and it will probably never be merged. So go one by one and it will be easy. And I'll show you how. There is the review button, which gives you the information, the difference between the two elements. So this is the old one and this is the new one. And there is the README. This is the old one and this is the new one. Okay. So this is the review stage. And then there is the commit element. And here I can say, okay, it makes sense. So that README is one merge request and guidelines is a new one, or if you want, you can have them both. So say stage all. So I will show you one by one. So this is now README, and then you say commit. Then a commit message. I need two more new lines, which will probably will not merged. Then you can say create a new branch and merge it. It gives you a default name, so you can give it a different one or just use this one. You can create a new branch and then commit it, or if we say I want to have both, so stage everything, then I can say create a new branch and a merge request. Otherwise it will be two steps. So I want everything and create a new branch and directly create a new merge request. Say commit. Okay. So then it goes to this page where it says, okay, I need two more new lines. It takes this as the title of the new merge request. Then some info about why, and so on. So that developers know why you want to have this. This is the feature branch, and it should be merged into the master branch. Okay, and submit merge request. Okay, now we are back at kiliwiki.org Senatus and the merge request, yeah, and there is the new merge request. Yeah. So now the developers from the committee can discuss the merge request, and then if everything is okay, they get the button and can merge it. Yeah. So two ways to contribute. First, user way create an issue, yeah, and developers will do the rest. Or if you want to save some time for developers and you want to be sure, or let's say the chance is higher that something is merged, then directly create a merge request. Why is the chance higher? Simply because it's less work for developers. That's it. Okay, so now we will use this merge request for consensus seeking in the next video. See you soon.